March 15, 2019 will go down as one of New Zealand's darkest days. 51 people were killed and many more injured after a terrorist opened fire inside two Christchurch mosques as worshippers met for Friday prayers. It prompted the government to act hard and fast. Jordan Oppert with more.
Scenes never witnessed in this country before. A whole city in lockdown after a gunman went on a terror-fueled rampage.
It is clear that this is one of New Zealand's darkest days.
Opening fire in both the Al Noor and Linwood mosques, live streaming the attack on social media. Brave officers stopped the alleged gunman mid-attack as he apparently headed to a third mosque. Brenton Tarrant stands trial next June.
Many of those who will have been directly affected by this shooting may be migrants to New Zealand. They may even be refugees here. They have chosen to make New Zealand their home, and it is their home. They are us.
That quote, "they are us," echoed by the nation and displayed along Christchurch's Rolleston Ave. Students came together and organised a vigil for the peers they lost.
There were students who had so much aspirations in life. You know, one wanted to be an engineer, an architect, one was an amazing footballer. And just for their life to be cut short, you know, it really makes me value life.
1 week after the attack, thousands of people from all around the country turned out for the call to prayer at Hagley Park, poignantly opposite Al Noor Mosque. Among them, survivors of the shooting. The Al Noor Mosque Imam's powerful speech broadcast to the world.
We are broken-hearted, but we are not broken.
2 weeks later, Hagley Park filled once again for the remembrance service.
On the edge of darkness, there rides a peace train.
Yusef Cat Stevens, a Muslim himself, making the trip to show his support.
Thank you. Peace. Assalamu alaikum. Peace be with you, and you know, and may God, you know, make it easy for you, because the difficulty is the ones who have been left and have to suffer the absence of their loved ones.
Fareed Ahmed, who lost his wife in the attack, was someone who embodied the forgiving spirit after it.
This heart doesn't lie that the pain I have gone through, that any human being should go through that kind of pain. That's why I have chosen peace, I have chosen love, and I have forgiven.
The shooting tragedy led to urgent government intervention. Within 6 days, all military-style semi-automatics were banned.
The time for the mass and easy availability of these weapons must end. And today, they will.
Gun reform legislation was introduced in the House, and the international campaign called the Christchurch Call was launched. Its aim to put a stop to extreme and terrorist content online.
What happened on the 15th of March in New Zealand was unprecedented in the way that it used the internet. And so with that does come a responsibility to try and make change.
The Royal Commission of Inquiry is set to report back next April. Through it all, the Muslim community have opened their homes and shared their stories.
I have 9 bullets hit me, and first one I hit it from my face here.
It's unlikely their suffering will ever be forgotten. Jordan Oppert, One News.